So hey everyone, welcome again on Devish Tech channel, and in this video we will going to work on the landing page of our shopping app. So in the landing page we have a bottom navigation bar only, and using that bottom navigation bar we can navigate into multiple tabs, like we have a home page, category page or the profile page. So in this video we will going to work on this bottom navigation bar first, then after that we will going to start working on the profile page. So let's start writing the code. But before I will start writing the code, I just want your help. Please don't forget to subscribe the channel, like the video and share the video to your friend and show your support. I made small video because whenever I get free time then I record the videos. So please have a patience. If I will make a long length video then it will take time, like 1 week or 2 weeks. So because of that only I made video, a short video, and release it on a 2 days or a 3 days. Okay, let's start writing the code. So let's start writing the actual code, and let's create a new folder inside the feature folder. Okay, and that will be our landing page. Okay, so let me create a new folder called landing page, and the folder model I'm using, this is called repository folder model. Some viewer asked me on a comment that please explain the architecture as well. So just go and Google about the repository folder model, and I'm using it that now, that we are going to put everything about that particular feature inside the that folder itself. So if I'm working on a landing page, so I will put everything related to the landing page on the landing page folder. That include UI or GetX controller or network calls or anything that is required, like model class or everything, I'm going to put inside the landing page folder only that is related to the landing page feature. So we are going to work on a landing page. So let's go and create a UI of the landing page. We can put inside the folder itself called UI, but I'm not going to put it. It's up to you. So this is a landing page folder and landing page.dart file. First thing, we have to import the material.dart file, and let's create a stateful widget. It will going to be, I mean, we have to handle the state of changing the tabs from one page to the another page. That's why it should be a stateful widget. So let me use the stateful widget thing. The name of the class of stateful widget is landing page, and instead of showing the container, let's show empty scaffold. Okay. And just don't worry about the linting errors, I mean warning, as of now. We're going to solve the linting warning as well. Let's go on the main.dart file, and instead of showing this scaffold, which is empty scaffold, let's show the landing page, and let's import it. So we have imported it. Okay, let me hit the save, and as of now we cannot see anything. But yeah, let's go over here and let's writing the code inside the scaffold. The first thing we are going to write, that is a bottom navigation bar. So inside this scaffold only we have a parameter called bottom navigation bar, and let's use the bottom navigation bar widget. Bottom navigation bar widget, and here we have to use the items. Item is a list of bottom navigation bar item, I mean list of widget which we wanted to show here in a bottom. So that should go inside here. So let's go and write our first bottom navigation bar item, and okay, so this is our first bottom navigation bar item. And if I will hit the save, okay, we have to provide the icon itself. Let me just give you an example. I'm not going to use the icons as of now. Like suppose if I will use this single bottom navigation bar item, then we will get an error. It will say you that the length of the bottom navigation bar item should be greater than or equal to 2, which means we should have at least 2 item in our bottom tab bar. Okay, so we actually need greater than 2 bottom navigation bar item, and we have a 3, right? We have a 3. We have a home page, categories and profile page, and we are not going to use these icons. We have to create our own kind of custom widget to show our images. Like we have a 3 different images, to show inside our bottom navigation bar item, the first widget is the first image is the categories for the category tab. Second image is the profile to show a profile tab, and the first image is the our own logo. Okay, so actually we have to use the image widget to show the images. Okay, so let me show you, then we will have a look. Okay, so this icon parameter actually take the widget, okay, the widget type of data. So we will going to use the image widget using the asset, and we have to provide the asset path, like the first item will going to be assets slash images. I'm going to provide the path, so the path is assets slash images and the name of the image. So if I will select this thing, look, not logo big, we have to use the logo black. Okay, and when we provide it, okay, and to remove this error we should have at least two items. So let me hit the save and see why we are getting. Okay, we have to use the title as well, each thing. So like instead of using the title, let's use the label. So it will be a home, the first one, and the second one will going to be a categories. So let me add the categories tab as well, categories. Okay, let's hit the save, and you will find that we have two tab, and you can see that when we use this image.asset, so we have to provide the height and width of this image, then only it will look nice, otherwise it will look big, right? And the same kind of property we have to write for this, or if we add a third icon, third item. So suppose I will add third item, so same kind of property I have to write here for this image.asset, or here this dot image.asset, or here, like I have to write the same kind of logic three times, or we have to create some object over here and pass it over here. So what I'm thinking that let's write a logic at the one place and use it in every places. Like suppose in future when we use a search bar on a app bar, the search button or a wishlist button, so instead of writing the same logic on every places, let's create a custom component for it. So that's why I have created this foundation folder, right? Let's create a custom component and let's use that custom component over the app. That's why the foundation folder is created. So I'm going to create a custom component, and that custom component I'm going to name it as a SP icon. What is the naming convention? SP means the shopping, okay, shopping short form is SP hyphen icon, because we are using this component as an icon for our app. That's why I'm using the name of this folder as a SP icon, and I'm going to create a SP icon dot dart file, and it will going to be a stateless widget. Why we use this landing page as a stateful widget? Because we have to manage the state, we have to convert one tab to the another tab, but this SP icon will going to be a stateless, because we just have to show the UI, nothing else. Okay, that's why I'm creating this SP icon as a stateless widget. So I will explain you everything. So let's create first a SP icon that will be a stateless widget. Stateless widget, and let's use the SP icon, and instead of showing the container we're going to use the image.asset. Okay, so let's use the image.asset and let's return it from here, and as you know that we had to generalize this SP icon, we have to take another parameter that will be a asset name. So let's create a parameter called asset name. Hope you are enjoying this video. I'm trying to explain everything very smoothly, so please have a patience. So let's take another parameter called asset name. oh my bad, it will be a capital string. And let's take it as a parameter from the file where we are going to use, and we should use as a required. Okay, and required, and this should be this dot asset name. Okay, and we're going to get the asset name. So let me first hit the save, and let me just use this SP icon here. Okay, and we have to provide the asset name. For this, the asset name will going to be the name of the image. So the first image will going to be a logo black. So let me use it. Let me just write the code, and you will going to get, I mean, you will understand everything. So, and we have to import it. Okay, so hit the save. And it is saying something. Oh, we have to use the asset name key. Okay, and hit the save. Let's provide the constant to remove the linting. Okay, and let's use the SP icon over here also. So I'm going to use the SP icon over here also, and I have to use the categories image for it. So let me go and find this. Okay, here we have the categories name. Let me write the code first, then you will get to know everything. And this is the set name of the categories. Okay, and the third tab will going to use the image of the profile. So let me find the profile, and let's use it on the third tab. So here we have provided the, okay, and we have to use the SP icon. I'm just forgetting it. Okay, let me just copy it again, and instead of this thing, let me use it over here. And let's provide the exact path, that will be a profile.png. I just do copy and pasting because I don't want it to do a mistake. And let's change the name of the label, it will be a profile, and hit the save, and you will find nothing is happening as of now. Because if I will go on SP icon, I'm using the hard coded image path as of now. So let's, instead of using this hard coded image path, let's use the dollar sign, and let's use the string interpolation and get the image path from the parent to the child, and let's use that asset name over here. And if I will hit the save, then automatically all the images is changed. And now we can customize this custom widget. We can provide the height. For our case, I'm going to use the height as a 25. We can provide a width. I'm going to use the 25 again and hit the save. And now look, it's looking great. Yeah, we can still not able to navigate from one page to the another page as of now. But yeah, it is looking now great. Now the image and everything is customized. Now what we have to do, and don't forget that all the images are uploaded on my link on my GitHub repository. You can find all the images on the GitHub repository itself. You can find the link of the GitHub repository in the description, and give a star to that GitHub repository. Okay, so now we are able to see all the tabs. What about changing the tab? To changing a tab, first we need to create another variable that will be a current index, and let's set the current index as a 0. And bottom navigation bar also provide a, okay, let me just do some styling. And the bottom navigation bar have another property called selected index. Okay, or it also have a current index. Okay, so current index, so let's use this current index and provide it. And apart from that, it have the on tab. So in the on tab, whenever we click on the tab, okay, so After clicking on attack, the magic will going to happen, and we're going to use the set state as of now. So if I will set the state and update the current index, and also this on tap will have a parameter called index. So whenever we will tap this tab or this tab, then automatically the index property will come and we will get the tapped index value. Like if I will tap here, then the index value will be 0. If I will tap here, then index value will be 1. And similarly for this, we have the 2. And we will going to set the current index as the index which we are getting. So automatically when we tap, then this current index will going to change and we will update the current index property over here. And now if I will click, then you can see that the index we are able to change. Now what about the colors which we showed, I showed you in the beginning of the video? Like when we click, then we are able to see the colors of the text in the image. Let's work on that also. So here what we have to do for that, whenever we will select a something, then we will going to change the selected color item color. Okay, so as of now let's use the hard-coded color, but I'm going to create a colors.dart file, and there only I will put that colors.dart file inside the foundation folder. I can create a method called I can create a folder called theme, and inside the theme folder I'm going to put the colors, spacing, everything inside this theme folder, but we will do it on a later part of video. Let's complete this bottom part. Okay, so the color I'm going to use, the color code I will put on a description. The color code is FE4166. Okay, so I tried to use this color as per the Myntra design. So yeah, so this is the color code, and we are also going to change the style of the selected label. Okay, and that will be a text style, and the font size will going to be a 13, then only it will look great. Font size will be 13, and hit the save, and you will find that it is looking great, but still we are not able to apply the color on the images. To apply a color on the image, we have to pass another property on the SP icon. We have to exactly pass two property. The first property will going to be a index of every tab. Okay, and we have to use it as an int. And the second property will be a current index. We need these two things to apply a color on the tab as well. Okay, so let's get it from the constructor. It will be this dot index, this dot current index. Okay, why it is, oh, we just did a this dot current index. Okay, and make it as a required, or else we have to put question mark over here. So I'm going to make it as a required because we are following the null safety. So let's add a required here, and here itself, and hit the save. Okay, we are getting, oh, we are able to miss the curly braces, that happened. Okay, and let's pass the index and current index over here. So I'm going to pass the index as a 0 because it's a 0th index tab, and current index will going to be the value which we are getting, we are setting all the time. Okay, the save, and what it is telling, oh, we need to remove this cons keyword which we added over here. Okay, remove it, and let's use this thing here also. So we need to pass, and I will change the name as 1, and here also we have to pass, and I have to change the name 2. So we are passing the tab index and the current index value. Why I'm passing? Because we have to write a logic over here. Like we have to apply the color of the image if the index value and the current index value, okay, if the index value and the current index value will have the same. Then only we will going to apply the color which we have. The color we are applying on a text, I wanted to apply on the image as well. And if don't have it, then we will going to use the colors.black. Let me just save and see the magic. So this is the logic, like if the index and the current index is same, then only apply the color on that particular tab and it is working perfectly. The last thing we are missing is changing the screen. So let's create the screen as well. So I have to create a three folder. The first folder will be a home page. Okay. And we are going to use the homepage.dart, or this is the naming convention we use on a dart. Okay, so home underscore page, don't use a capital letter or something, and it will going to be a state full widget. Okay, home page, we have to import the material.dart package. Okay, and let's use empty scaffold and let's show the in a body, let's show a center widget along with a child with text which will tell the name of the page. It will be a home page. Don't forget to, I mean, as of now, just forget about this landing issue and let's go on a landing page and let me create a list of widget and it will be a pages and I'm going to use this home page first, again a home page and again a home page as of now. But later point of video, I mean later point of this series, I'm going to use different widgets. Okay, so this pages is considered all three kind of stateful widget, or let me make another one, and third one you can do by your own. Let me make a profile page, I mean profile feature, and let me put the profile.dart file over here, profile.dart file, and let me import the material.dart package and state full widget, and it will be name will be class is profile, and instead of showing the container, let me go on a home page we just created. Okay, and let's use the whole thing on this profile.dart, and instead of showing it as this, let me use the profile. Okay, okay, so remaining the second one you will create by your own, and let me use it over here. Okay, so suppose we have a three different pages, 1, 2, and 3. So to navigate on a three different pages, we just have to use this pages variable we just created. And just after the bottom navigation bar, let's use the body parameter and let's use these pages. And what we have to just do, we have to use the current index. So all the time when the current index will change, the page will going to be changed. Like if we tap on a profile, then we are in a profile page. If we tap on a home, then it will be a home page. So, and the categories one you can add by your own, or I can add, but you can skip this part. But yeah, don't forget to subscribe the channel if you just skipping this part. So I'm going to create a categories folder. Okay, and I have to do the same, like I have to create a categories.dart file, and in the categories.dart file we have to import the material.dart package, and of course it will going to be a stateful widget as you know. And let's use the categories. Maybe the spelling name can be wrong. I do a lot of spelling mistake, but yeah. So here, let me use it. categories. Instead of the container, let me use the categories. Let's name it as a categories. Okay, hit the save. And let's use these categories in our landing page. Okay, let's do it quickly because we already late. This video may become a lengthy one. Okay, so let me refresh the page. Let's see what will happen. It's supposed to be a categories text. Okay, so now this is a home page, this is a category page, and this is a profile page. So now we are able to go on a different pages, and in the next video we will going to work on the home in the profile page first. So please don't forget to subscribe the channel, like the video, and share the video with your friend. I really need your help and motivation. Thank you all. Happy coding. See you on the next video.